Howdy and hello, and welcome back to Mike's Game Domain. This is Mike. We're playing Total War Warhammer as the Vampire Counts under the guide of Vlad von Karstein, the Champion of the Dark. So, I hope you're enjoying this series. I hope you're enjoying my content. Feel free to leave me comments, likes, subscriptions, whatever you feel like doing. All about the interaction. So let's just jump right in. We're only on turn 36. I kind of feel like we're moving this campaign a little quick for my taste, but we'll just keep pushing forward. So Graveguard are obviously great. This is the Graveguard buffs. They're very sturdy. They're very good. The ethereal units are interesting. I find them to be a bit underwhelming. They're kind of, it's one of those things where they're kind of hard to fight against. If you don't have magic attacks, you're going to really struggle to beat them. But for some reason, when I play with them, they just don't seem to do a whole lot. So, we will play with them. We're going to recruit them, but I don't think I'm going to let them be my main sort of lines. I don't think they're really built for that. Or at least that's been my experience. Holy god. Sweet. I think you have enough goblin bosses there? Grimgor? You wanna be my vassal? I'll protect you. That's too bad. Good luck with that. Good luck with that Grimgor problem. Alright, so we've got a healthy income. We've got some garrison happening. Yeah, we're doing okay. Sylvania's looking nice now. We kind of got to be careful, too, that we don't expand too much, because we'll trigger the chaos event early, which is fine. I usually do trigger it early, but it's not always what you want to do. Hey, there's the Beastman. I've been hiding this whole time, causing corruption in my lands. Alright. So keep in mind, the goal here is still just to get a bunch of stuff to die, so we can build up these Raise the Dead pools. So let's see what we're working with here. This one I think is decent. 4,600, yeah! Vargolf, Crypt Horrors, Mortis Engine. These are some very high tier units, so to be able to grab them instantly, I mean, it is 1,300 bucks, but we're gonna get to a point where money is almost a non-issue, because we can raise and whatchamacallit. Let's get some money happening. We can raise and disband units at will. Corruption? I don't usually care that much about corruption. You can play a very grindy vampire count campaign where you just work on building corruption. Like, you level up all your heroes to give corruption, and you build those whatever it's called. The building that creates corruption. And the problem is that the spread of corruption is very slow. I mean, it would take maybe 20 or 30 turns just to spread it over here to a reasonable amount, and then you gotta rinse, repeat every single province. It just takes forever. So that is a one way to play. I did it once. It was really fun. I actually did a game, a play like that as Musilin over here, whatever the faction is. And I had the Tomb Kings mod on, so I was not using any vampire units. I was using exclusively skeletons, and I went for corruption, which, now that I think about it, corruption is more of a vampire thing than a Tomb Kings thing. But it was okay. It was kind of cool moving through Bretonnia and just corrupting. There's a lot of forests. It was before the Wood Elves released, but anyway, that was neat. What just happened here? Okay, declared war on Skarsnik. This is our first time fighting greenskins, I think. So, we're gonna win, obviously, but let's fight it. You gotta kind of remember that you play this game to fight these battles. It's very easy to just start auto-resolving your way through the campaign because you're enjoying, you know, momentum and progress, and then you get into the middle game and maybe even to the late game and you realize, I haven't fought a battle in like 50 turns. And suddenly this just isn't the same experience. So anyway, something to think about. Oh yeah, unfortunately we don't vanguard our whole shiblab. Why are you not hidden by these trees? I feel like you maybe should be. These trees? These trees. There you go. Alright, find the tree. Skeletons are just great. So you can control click, something that's kind of cool. Actually, another Twitch guy, Ninja Hund, taught me this. But you can hold control and click your units, and it'll actually assign them, it'll arrange them in the order. So I clicked two spearmen, or two swordsmen, and then spears, and then back. And so you can, you know, alternate like that. That's one way to do it. Another cool thing you can do is actually visually represent what you want by doing it like this. And I kind of prefer this, even though it takes a little bit extra work. But you'll notice that even though the units rearranged themselves on the battlefield in the order I wanted, they didn't rearrange their unit cards. And I just like having the visual indicator here that represents. So now if I drag this out, it goes spear, spear, sword, sword, spear, sword, sword, spear. So same thing. Both are fine. If you're if you're constrained on time at all, Ninja Hun's method is quicker because you're just control clicking. But like I said, I do like to have this visually represent how my units are organized. I'm a visual person in general, so it just kind of helps me. But to each their own. All right. Let's go over here, and we just kind of have a big donkey line, so these guys are not going to do anything. And we're attacking, so we'll draw if the time runs out. There's no reason to let that happen. Let's take a look at some of these green skin units. So we've got trolls here. They have green skin war paint on their tummies. That's kind of cool. Yeah, I mean, they're trolls. They're just kind of disgusting. I think there's even flies. Yeah. Oh, we've got movement. We've got some gobos here. These are goblin spearmen. Kind of the basic goblin unit. Pretty darn cool. I'm actually recording in 1080p this time just to see what a difference that makes in terms of file size. The game is just so gorgeous. It just doesn't do it justice to record in 720. And I would love to post 4K video so you can see what I'm seeing, but I think that those file sizes might be a little out of hand. If someone wants to see that, just leave a comment and I'll record at least one episode in 4K for you. That is not a problem. Alright, so we've got all this fun stuff happening. What's a good target for my hounds? Kind of all this is decent. Obviously the archers would be ideal. Trolls actually have 30 armor. I guess it's these like scaly skin features. But they have, I think they have area of effect damage, so they'll probably beat up my hounds pretty badly. I think I'm going to hold off on those. I'm out of range of the archers, right? Yeah. Just wait till my line get here. Lines get here. Alright. So why don't you start closing them in? I definitely want to get my spears into... Oops. You can hit escape if you are in the middle of issuing a command that you no longer want to issue. And it'll cancel it. I definitely want to get my spears into the trolls. Trolls are pretty dangerous. There's only a few models. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I guess I could have just looked at a number over here. So 9 trolls, but each one is actually pretty hard to kill. They're best killed with missiles. They're actually pretty easy to take down with bullets or arrows. Unfortunately, for the vampire counts, no missiles. So we'll have to figure something else out. Hello. Get in there, buddy. We could... Yeah, that's not really a good wind of death situation. Alright. I mean, it doesn't really matter. I'm gonna just squash these guys anyway. Alright, so there's some invisible stalking units. Let's make sure we get spears. Uh-oh. Into the trolls. Didn't happen. Let's give our spears a dance macabre. Power reserve. Let's get skeletons in the rear of this little cluster, which will help contain it. We can do a wind of death just to see. It doesn't really matter, but it's a fun spell. Woo! So literally just kills. Oh, okay, I was going to say. You can see it killed three things. So winds of death used to absolutely crush everything. It was really powerful. But I think some adjustments have been made to the spell, so I don't think it's quite worth the mana at this point. But it's still a neat effect, so I'll use it just for that reason. Alright, so trolls are going to rout and come back. So I'm going to chase them down with spears. pretty much all green skin units will do that. Oh, okay. Well, I guess that happens. Let's heal them. Oh, that's my raise the dead ones. Whoops. Hey, can you heal raise the dead guys? You can. Interesting. It's not too effective though. To kind of mitigate the whenever you raise the dead, the units will deteriorate. They're kind of crumbling already. That's what that purple and red lightning is. So I guess you can stall that a little bit, but not a whole lot. Alright, that's enough for that. Good fight. Well, not really, but good fight for me, not for you. Who did well? Wolves did really well. Swords did well. Spears did okay. Prevented their trolls from doing anything, that's great. Gabo's really tore into me, wow. Oh, of course, this is Skarsnik. Oh, yes, sir. Now, what is super fun about subjugating... are you gonna be a jerk? Your presence in our holes. What's really, really fun about subjugating versus... So you could say, like, oh, well, in the normal game, you can forge alliances, right? And you can kind of do the same thing where you fight battles with your allies, blah, blah, blah. True. They can join you on the battlefield, but where that really falls apart is in the diplomacy. So what'll happen is you'll start to form alliances, and it becomes a liability because your allies will attack your other allies. And all of a sudden, this network of allies you build just completely falls apart. It's really stupid how that works. I mean, I guess it's okay occasionally, but it happens way too much, in my opinion. Alliances, I mean, an ally of your ally is going to... You're not just going to declare war on them willy-nilly just because they're right next to you. You know what I mean? So I feel like that's a little bit of a misstep. It kind of ruins the whole diplomacy, and that's why I'm having to deal... that's why I'm having to work with vassals instead. Shouldn't be just talking. Let's do something. Yeah, let's do that. Vlad, do I want you to do anything? I mean, obviously. You're Vladdy Daddy. Let's get you... Growth is pretty cool. That's useless. That's okay. I think I want him to have a discount on Raise the Dead. Excuse me, since that's... Wow. Since that's kind of the theme of our let's play here. Alright, let's get him into a raiding stance. Oops. Man. Stupid mod. I do have a mod that prevents you... It changes the movement requirements to get into these various stances. And so, raiding stance requires 75% of your movement range. It takes 50 normally, so that really limits when you can pop in and out of raiding stance, which I kind of like, because raiding has to be more deliberate. However, when you have a faction like mine that takes attrition pretty much on the entire map, that can be a big penalty, but it's no big deal. We're clearly powerful enough as it is. I'm not too worried about it. Magical Animus. Okay, so that's just a strict... leadership buff. Cooldown, that's fun at the end. Arcane Conduit's rather nice. It lets you push your reserve Winds of Magic into your actual pool quicker. Well, yeah, what I was saying is, when you have vassals, they instantly adopt identical diplomacy with you. So all of your enemies become their enemies, all of your allies and vassals become their allies. Which is great, so that means that this green skin ally, or vassal that I just picked up, is not going to declare war on Nuln, and nor is it going to declare war on its neighbor, which is dwarves. So I can actually have an alliance of greenskins, dwarves, and humans, which is the whole point of what I'm working towards. Empire, I believe, is... not my favorite people, so let's move in on their territory. Let's get a short raid. Yeah, so only the vassal system lets you do that, and that's why I play like this. I don't expect these vassals to last the entire game. They'll probably last a while because I like to protect them. I feel like that's kind of the trade-off. They give up their freedom as an independent nation, and I do my best to protect them. But, you know, if it's me or them, yeah, You are the vassal. But anyway, yeah, so that allows you to have really cool alliances forged that are not going to be broken, they're just imploding on themselves left and right, which is kind of what happens normally. Uh-oh. So let's go help our vassal out. Let's get Skarsnik's forces here. Tell them to help. Let's get our own forces. We'll tell them to help, or we'll just go over there. And that is not in range. That's a shame. Well, I want to... Wait. Dang it, I can't see the reinforcement banner. Or range. I want to say that's in range. It should be. We're taking attrition, which stinks, but... Tis what it is. We can just raise the dead, which is kind of cool. Alright. So, whenever the dwarves decide to assault this... The city will be there to help, which is fun. Vlad, let's try to get you into a reading stance. There we go. Jeez. Alright. If you can hear my son crying, I'm sorry, he's in the other room. It's pretty late, so he's teething. I'm not ignoring him because I'm a bad parent. But my wife is in there taking care of him, so... If you hear that, I apologize, but I don't want you to think I'm just ignoring him. I'm aware. Very aware that he's there. Let's see. Alright, that's it for this turn. Let's see if we can pull this cool cross-mogination fight happening. Oh good, hungry. Got Kirknorn, Wood Elves. Okay, so one of the downsides is that other nations will declare war on your kind of like power group. So the Wood Elves wanted to attack that goblin army, and in order to do that they had to declare war on my entire vassal, you know, array. So we are all now at war with Wood Elves, which works for me. Alright, let's colonize. May have not have been that smart, as it turns out. Will you get off your high horse? Do something? Well, you're a dwarf, so... Maybe not that high. Yeah, I mean, doing the vassal thing is fun, but it is kind of challenging as the vampires, because all of the lands that I want my vassals to join me on, they're going to be taking attrition on. And when I want to help my vassals, I'm going to be taking attrition, so... Sort of a water and oil situation, but... We'll make it work. Alright. I care least about skeleton spearmen, so let's do that. Would love it. Oh, are we allies? We are allies. That's right. There we go. Cool. Don't raid me, bro. Alright, we're gonna come deal with these idiots. They're still healing? That seems a little weird. Hang on. Alright, we are back. Sorry about that. I had to go make a bottle. No big deal. So, where were we? I don't recall. Fort Obstery. I want to start building a couple of these military buildings. Especially the one that matters most, let's take a look, is this guy here. The one that gives you ethereal units. A, they don't show up a ton in the... And the raise the dead options, and also that's the one that gives you the heroes that I like. The White King especially is a great hero, and the Banshees are pretty good at taking down enemy. Oh wow, I can actually build? Oh no, I can't. Okay. I was gonna say, that'd be neat if I could look at this building array and choose my construction, but nope. Alright. Yeah, these other buildings, I mean, this doesn't give you heroes, this one doesn't give you heroes. It does give you access to Vargolfs, which I have a feeling I'm going to end up training a ton because of dwarves. We'll see, though. You can usually pick up one, maybe two Vargolfs through Raise the Dead, but I don't think I've ever seen more than that. So I don't anticipate relying on Raise the Dead for those guys. Kind of the same thing with Graveguard. You'll pick up like two Graveguard, and then you have to let the Raise the Dead pool replenish for... I don't know, a couple turns, and then they'll be back and get a couple more. But anyway, yeah, the downside of using Raise the Dead is you don't get any chevrons on your units. They're all going to come in at level 0. If you actually recruit, you can use... Really? Alright, homie. If you actually recruit, you can use White Kings and other heroes to boost, and technology, I believe, to boost the sort of default level of your units. I think I might just attack this force. We don't have a great force for fighting dwarves, as I've said. But it's us and our vassal against the dwarves. The dwarves. Hello, dwarves. Oh, they have a pretty bottom tier army too. I mean, don't get me wrong, these are tough units, but certainly beatable. What does our ally have? Nothing and 8. Oof. Well, at least halberds are armor piercing. Actually not going to be that easy of a fight. Where did that goblin army... I told you to... Oh, I see. You're going after. Yeah, actually, you can do that. That's cool. Clever little goblin. You do that. Oh my god. It's so hard to get dwarves to do anything. Like, get off your butts. Seriously. Alright, so that's all happening. We can now assault this,
Never.
Force. They're still replenishing. That has to be some kind of weird bug. Oh, those mortars are gonna crush us. I do want to fight that, but I'm looking forward to this battle more, so.
Thou darest.
Let's just go for it. Oh. Well, I don't want to solo them. I don't think I can, so. That might be fun. We're gonna take attrition. If we weren't already low, I would say it'd be worth it. But let's go ahead and scoot back. We'll do a little push and pull with them. But we might end up setting up an ambush because it's fun. Yeah, still not 100% sure about that. I don't really want to build up my growth. Oh yeah, I do. Kind of don't want to use up one of my best slots. So I'm gonna destroy that. Alright, let's just let the game play out a little bit and then we'll make a decision. It's not like this is getting any better, so let's go ahead and fight this guy. This might be our big battle for the episode. I wanted to have the dwarf army crushed, but they apparently didn't like their odds, so fine with me. Alright, so we're going to be assaulting a fortified... Oh god, I just realized that. They don't have any garrison troops, but they still get to use the walls. So we're going to be dealing with that gate issue. And we have zombies attacking walls. But we do have Vanguard. Oh wait, no, it doesn't matter. It gives you like 2 feet advantage. Oh, this is going to be a ball sack of a battle. We're up against 4 mortars. So, I think this is, the best strategy here is going to be to divide up our force into separate sort of assault forces, whatever you want to call that. Let's get all these guys back. I would prefer to maybe even hide them and just bring them in once I've dealt with the gates and such. Let's go there, let's get another skelly over there. That way they're not taking fire from these towers. Oh, wait. Oh, wait. Never mind. Yeah, they got holes all over there. Alright, so we're not going to worry about that plan. That would be the plan I would deploy if they had a full wall, but they got broken walls. I still will leave my skeletons hidden. Vlad, you can... Oh, you can hide in the woods too. Alright. Why not? You guys can come over here. Bargolfs, I don't think you can hide in the woods, which makes sense. Let's kind of get them off on their own. Magically, the AI will deploy its forces wherever you position your forces, which is interesting. I guess it makes sense. As the defender, you have the right to see what's coming at you. So, sure. But anyway, since we're all deploying largely on the left side, we can hide these guys on the right, and if they want to attack you with towers, they have to waste a whole unit over here. Which doesn't seem good for them. It does seem good for us. Kind of a win-win. Blood Knights are pretty valuable. Let's hide them as well. Till we can push in. Alright, so we're gonna take Vlad and the zombies into battle. Do our best. Vlad, you can just charge in, homie. I doubt you're gonna die. Oh, they did. They went for it. Okay. Well, here's where that doesn't pay off. So now we get Vargeist to just come in and destroy those gunners. Although, we are taking cannonball fire. Hmm. Can we scoot out of range? Yeah. Oh, guns! Oh, Vargeist! Don't die! Oh, more guns? Wow. They really committed to these Vargeist. Hmm. That's not good. Hello. That is not good indeed. Well, we're already in it, so pulling out now isn't going to do anything. I'll just slam in. Wow, they are really defending this wall more than I expected. The Vargeist should be able to handle two sets of, I would think. Oh yeah, I can heal from across the map as well. So let's abuse that. Oh no, can't do it when they're on the wall. Get him off the wall just for a second. Shit, did he do it? Come on, buddy. Are you out of range? Is there a range on this after all? Yeah, there is. Okay, never mind. Never mind, Vlad. Why don't you just get in there and attack the gunners that are shooting? Really? You're gonna go that way? There you go. Alright, zombies, what are you doing? So useless. By Van Hell. We'll let him fight those guys. Speed, melee attack, recharge rate. I do want to get into the, jeez, I wish I could heal these guys. Poor Vargeist. Oh, and they're on the ground too. Well, we did take out two sets of gunners, so still feel like that's put to good use. We could try to swing them out and grab a healing off of our hero, which isn't a terrible idea. Alright, get in there, keep attacking. Oh. Yeah, I'm gonna swing. Okay, guys, seriously, push in. You're killing me, zombies. Which is hilarious. I think at this point we'll go ahead and get our other forces in there. Hopefully the zombies should clear before we get there. Alright, so Vlad, we need your magic. There, on them. Beautiful. They're regrouping. I kind of like this matchup, so let's go back and smash them a bit. Let's just have our zombies push all the way to the back. They're not going to do anything in this fight unless I give them Dance Macabre. So I'm not too worried about them. I'd almost rather just raise the dead. Alright. Not gonna do anything there. Blood Knights will though. Are you on a horse? You usually are. Oh, you're on foot. Interesting. Alright, let's get our Blood Knights through if we can. Oh, just gumming up everything, aren't you? Bloody Knights. Alright, well, get in there and fight, I guess. Let's try to push through what we can here. Oh, oh, oh. We don't want to do that. Can our hounds break free? Maybe, I doubt it though. Alright, how are the Vargeist doing? Did they die? Oh, they're still good. Vargeist, come over here. Get shot a bit. They'll survive though. Yeah, we're doing well. So, what I wanted to do is just get the attention of the the mortars so that they're not just plowing through my forces. I don't think any of you are going to be able to actually fight him. And these are skeletons. Let's get them out of there. These are skeletons too. Alright, push in. Push in, people. Push in. Push in. Alright, we do cause terror, and we can now get behind them to flank, so that's good. Von Karstein, do the thing! Ah, he doesn't have, I'm trying to remember all the spells he has so I can make them count. Yeah, that will be good. Buff up all my dudes so they actually can put in some work here. Let's get them involved. Well, Blood Knights are made to kill other horses, so we should do pretty well in this fight. We are taking mortar fire. I guess they're sacking their pistoliers to just pin down my Blood Knights, which is a great strategy, as it turns out. Alright, Vargeist, you still alive? Come over here. We need some healing. Yeah, this zombie army is just, it really lacks mobility to complete a siege. It'll work. We're gonna win. It's just not gonna be the cleanest win. Let's get you there. Vargeist, come over here. One thing you may have seen me do, which I think is really cool, whenever you're wanting to heal, you can click the healing spell, and you can actually click on the unit card that you want to heal, so you don't have to find the unit if it's over here and actually click in the right spot. Sometimes you'll miss and you end up healing, you know, the wrong unit. It's a big pain in the butt. You can actually just heal the unit card itself, which is pretty awesome. Oh my god, my Blood Knights are just getting bludgeoned. Dirty. Talking and playing is surprisingly challenging. Okay. More Blood Knights, no. All my fast units took a ton of damage. Leadership. We should be fine now. I really want my Hounds, my Blood Knights, and my Vargeist in the same area so I can do one of these guys. Vargeist. At this point it's kind of silly, but I still do want to heal. So Vargeist are healing, Blood Knights are healing, Hounds are healing, that's good. I don't care about kills. I just would rather maybe cast one more healing spell. What is this? Yeah, I don't care. Alright, so that's that. We did it. Zombies can put forth a siege, I guess. Can win. I'm just gonna ride this one more time. Then we will. Might as well. Get some health back on our Blood Knights. Vargeist. Vargeist are fully healed almost. These guys are fully healed. I can actually heal my Blood Knights a little more. So yeah, you can see I clicked the Blood Knights unit card, even on Overcast, which has an area of effect, and it still casts it over them, so great little trick for making sure you're casting your spells precisely. Did we end up killing the bad guy? I think we did. Awesome. Alright, so that's that. Actually, we didn't take that many losses, surprisingly. The Outriders ripped us up. But that's... what were they fighting? I don't even remember. I think they were fighting zombies, so whatever. Cool. So we're going to grab this Aberheim back. 12% reheals is just going to give us basically a full army again. Oof. I was about to disband this, but we're already at a gold chevron, so 24-13 on the zombie is pretty darn good. And then you got to imagine that you add the Dance Macabre on top of that. Was it like I think it's going to go up to probably like 65 melee attack, which is just pretty badass for a zombie. I mean, you're only doing 18 points of damage per hit, but if you're hitting every hand or every time you strike, that's not bad. Blood Knights. Yeah, we're doing good. So that's going to be it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed it. This is in 1080p, so hopefully there you notice a difference. But I appreciate you watching, and I'll catch you later. Have a good night. Bye.